working in the field definitely has rewards and frustrations. I think that probably the rewards have to do with working hard, knowing that the work that MSF is doing is helping, using clinical skills in places where maybe there's a shortage of people who have those skills. That's definitely very, very rewarding. The biggest rewards come from the relationships with national staff and with patients who come to the hospital. Frustrations have to do with political situations, with people being poor, with not being able to get supplies. Those are the inevitable things that happen in jobs where there's a lot of stress. It gets frustrating if you can't control everything. One of the things about MSF life is that one works and lives with the same people. That can be absolutely fantastic if the team is cohesive and if the team members like each other. I've met people who will probably be lifelong friends. I cannot say enough good things about the dedication, work ethic, and the personal ethics of the people who were on our team in Duakwe. It was nice to have those people be supportive during the workday, whether it was the surgical team, or those people were the ones who did C-sections when we had emergencies, or there was the pediatrician who would take care of the babies. It was wonderful to work with them during the day and on the serious matters of clinical issues, but also nice to have fun with them. We ate dinner together, we ate lunch together, we would often go out for a beverage after work, we walked back and forth to the hospital from our house, getting to know each other, sharing stories from the day, sharing stories from our other lives. I had very, very good experiences with the team members. It's interesting to be an older person on a mission. Because like this, MSF is all, I think, is an organization of young people, although I don't really know the statistics. But certainly those of us who are in our 50s and 60s and 70s are probably fewer than people who are in their 20s and 30s and 40s. Our team actually had very young people and then the older group. And it's very true that the older people sort of hung around together and the younger people hung around together. But at mealtimes we did mix. But it was nice to have both of those groups. I actually liked being part of an international team. The language barrier was a problem. Says I certainly don't speak French well enough to understand the nuances of the language, which means that any jokes that people told that were at all sophisticated certainly went over my head. There are other English-speaking members of the team who are, I think, were more frustrated than I with the language problem. But for the most part, I really wanted to learn French, and so felt very grateful to the other members for their patience in teaching me French. I learned all sorts of words in French that one does not learn in high school French, but that's fine. That's part of the experience. It's interesting. We're in a place that's poor, and we had difficult work conditions, and so it seemed a little strange to also say that I learned about French wine and French cheese on an MSF mission, but it is true. We didn't have a lot of French wine and a lot of French cheese, but when people came from France, they would bring us treats. And so from my French counterparts, I learned I learned about French wine and French cheese, which I would never have guessed would happen in an international humanitarian mission, but it did.
One of the things that I was extremely surprised about was how many smokers there were in our project. I think that out of the 12 of us who regularly ate dinner together and who were the team, I think there were probably 9 smokers. And I was extremely surprised by that. People were generally considerate of the few of us who didn't smoke. They would sort of turn their heads and smoke to the side. But it's not at all like the non-smoking places in the U.S. where people really don't smoke. In our house in MSF, people were not supposed to smoke in the house, but there was someone who smoked in her bedroom and walked by her door and you could definitely smell it. And after dinner or at a meeting, people were always lighting up and people's chains smoked. It was incredible. Mostly, I just moved out of the way of the smoke. I don't like it, but I'm not allergic to it, and it bothers me. It irritates my eyes. But because we ate outside and we had all of our meetings outside, it's possible to move out of the way. And also, for me, I did not make an issue out of it because there were other issues for me that were much more important. I was much more concerned with making sure that the issues that I had with maternity were addressed, and I didn't want to have any personal issues with the other team members get in the way of my constant demands for materials, for mattresses for the women who are laboring on the floor, for more water, for more medicines. I didn't want that to be at all affected by anything personal. So I let it go.